Hello everyone, in this video session I am going to explain part 191 of Java for tester series, that is multiple catch blocks. So we can use more than one catch blocks in the try catch block statements. We can use multiple catch blocks in the try catch block statements. So before I practically demonstrate how to use this multiple catch blocks in the try catch block statements, let me show you few things. Fine. So let me show you the basic code for getting an arithmetic exception. So what is the basic code for getting an arithmetic exception? You can simply say int a is equal to divide some number by zero, guys. Okay. If you try to divide some number by zero in Java, that will result in arithmetic exception. So run this Java application. As you can see, we got arithmetic exception. So more details about this exception I already covered in the one of the previous videos. So similarly, if I try to assign more than the required values into an array, for example, there's something like integer array, and have set the size of this array to only two elements. Okay, that is but if I try to assign some like this, okay, if I try to assign a value to the element which is not there, so two elements means a of 0 and a of 1 is only possible, a of 2, a of 3 cannot be possible. If you still try to store some value into this such kind of array element, it will result in array index out of bounds exception. So right click, run as Java application. Observe that we got array index out of bounds exception. Only index 0 and 1 is possible because only two elements. Here index value is 3. You cannot assign a value to an element with index 3 into an array whose size is only 2. That is only index 0 and index 1 is possible. So in this kind of cases, we are going to get another type of exception known as array index out of bounds exception. Even I covered this array index out of bounds exception in one of the previous videos in detail. And another type of exception, guys, let's say some string str is equal to, I'm giving my name here. Okay, now I will say str dot caret. I'll give the index value as 55. Okay, is there any index value 55? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Only up to 11 index is possible. But here I am saying retrieve the character which is available in this particular string at the index 55. Only 11 is there. But here I am asking to retrieve from 55th index, which is not there in this string literal, right? So in such kind of cases, we are going to get which kind of exception? Another exception, guys. String index out of bounds exception we are going to get. Okay, string index out of bounds exception. This is third type of exception. Okay, like this, in Java we have different types of exceptions, right? So but guys, what I will do here is I will create a basic try catch block. Now you got some idea about different exceptions that are possible, right? So one example I showed you of arithmetic exception, another one is of array index out of bounds exception, and another one is string index out of bounds exception. Three practical demonstrations I showed you right away, right? Now I'll go with the basic try catch block, which has only one catch block. Okay, inside the try block I will give something like int a is equal to 10 by 0. What exception we will get here, guys? If I say int a is equal to 10 by 0, what type of exception we are going to get? This will result in arithmetic exception, right? So I'll write something like this. Arithmetic exception, right? Exception e. Okay, so system.out.println, I will write some specific statements like arithmetic exception handled. Okay, so if you get an arithmetic exception, I want this catch block to be invoked and this arithmetic exception to be handled. So when I run this, right click, run as Java application, I'll get arithmetic exception handling message. That's fine. So what if here I don't have a statement that throws arithmetic exception. Instead, I have an array, okay, integer array, let's say int a, integer array is called new int of sum 2. I am trying to assign a of sum 9 with some value, say sum 5, okay. So only two, the index 0 and 1 is possible, but here index 9 is there. In such kind of cases, if I run this, right click run as Java application, I will get array index out of bounds exception. Here, whatever the exception I am handling is arithmetic exception, but here I am getting array index out of bounds exception. Since that exception is not handled in the catch block, okay, we got the exception directly in the output. Okay, exception is not handled and printed into the output. So to avoid that, I can write another catch block is, okay. So this statement may have arithmetic exception. This statement may result in arithmetic exception. It may result in array index out of bounds exception. So to handle such kind of multiple situations, I may write array index out of bounds exception like this, okay. So if not this catch block, this catch block will be invoked, okay. Multiple options, system.out.println, system.out.println. Here if this particular catch block is kind of invoked, I'll print array index out of bounds exception handled, okay. Array index out of bounds exception handled, okay. So if I run this code, will the exception will be handled, guys? Here we have two catch blocks and this code is going to throw array index out of bounds exception. So in the first catch block will be checked and it has arithmetic exception, so this particular catch block will not work. It will not be, this first catch block will not be able to handle this array index out of bounds exception thrown by this try block, and it, the control will go to the second catch block where we have the array index out of bounds exception to be handled. Since we are getting the array index out of bounds exception, the second catch block will be invoked and this particular statement will be printed, okay. Right click run as Java application. Sorry, I selected wrong option, so let me run it again. Right click run as Java application. As you can see, array index out of bounds exception got handled, okay. Array index out of bounds exception got handled. What if here we have, what if I comment this, and if I have this int a is equal to 10 by 0, in this kind of situation, which, what message will be displayed, guys? Arithmetic exception handled or array index out of bounds exception handled? Here, since this particular statement throws arithmetic exception, this catch block will be invoked and this particular statement will be printed, okay. Let's see whether we are getting the proper output or not. You see arithmetic exception, and if I comment this and if I uncomment this, which message will be printed, which exception will be handled? Array index out of bounds exception should be printed. So right click run as Java application, okay, like this, array index out of bounds exception, okay. So like this, guys, we can have multiple catch blocks specified in the try catch block statements. So what if we got a situation where we didn't get arithmetic exception or we didn't get any array index out of bounds exception, okay. Despite of having multiple catch blocks, one catch block is taking care of the arithmetic exception, another catch block is taking care of the array index out of bounds exception, but still we got another type of exception from the try block. Let's say string str is equal to Arun Motori. If I say str dot caret some 55 index, okay. Here string index is up to 11 only, but I am giving 55 index. In such kind of cases, I am going to get a different exception, guys. Other than arithmetic array index, I am going to get another exception type. So if I run this, I am going to get the error directly in the exception, directly in the output, because these two catch blocks cannot handle this exception. This exception is different exception, guys. That is string index out of bounds exception. But here we have the catch blocks to handle only arithmetic exception and array index out of bounds exception. So guys, finally what we can do here is, we don't know what type of exception that can be thrown, right? If you are clear, like this statement may lead into arithmetic exception, then you can provide this catch block. If there are some block of code which has possibility of both arithmetic exception and array index out of bounds exception, you can provide two catch blocks. But if you have a block of code which may give you arithmetic exception, array index out of bounds exception, or a different exception that we cannot imagine. In that case, we can simply say catch, simply give exception E, okay, exception E, system dot out dot println, okay, exception got handled. Here we are giving a generic message, guys, okay? We don't know which exception we are going to handle, okay? So this exception class will handle all the types of exceptions. It may be arithmetic exception or array index out of bounds exception or any other exception. Since we already have this arithmetic exception, this catch block will take care of the arithmetic exception. We already have this array index out of bounds exception in the catch block, second catch block. This will take care of the second, okay, second type of exception, array index out of bounds exception. And if not arithmetic array index, if another exception is coming, in that case, third catch block will take care of that, guys. We'll get exception got handled message. It is a generic message, okay? And this kind of catch block should be provided at the end, guys, okay? All the all the child class exception classes should be provided first in the order, okay? First the arithmetic exception comes, because arithmetic exception is the child class of the exception predefined class in Java. Even array index out of bounds is also child class of the exception. So first child class exception classes should be there in the catch blocks, and finally we have to go to the parent. Fine, right click run as Java application. You see exception got handled will be printed, because this particular statement is throwing you the sync index out of bounds exception. Here first catch block arithmetic exception no match, so this will not be invoked. Second one is array index out of bounds exception, which is no match with the sync index out of bounds exception, so this is also not matched. And finally we'll go with the third catch block. Okay, here we have exception class, which is a parent class of all of different exception classes in Java, like arithmetic exception, array index out of bounds exception, and string index out of bounds exception. So this exception class can take care of all the other exception types. Hence this particular catch block will be invoked, and the string index out of bounds exception will be handled by this catch block, and this particular message will be printed on handling, after handling. Okay, so guys, like this we can have multiple catch blocks in the try catch block statement, starting with the child class, child exception classes, and going to the parent exception classes. Okay, so run this and we already got the answer. Okay, so to upgrade this, we can also in the real time we can actually do something like this. Again, catch block, you can say string index out of, if you know the exception type, then you can simply provide this child class exception classes before the final exception class. Okay, for safe side you can keep the exception class at the end, guys. Okay, like this, catch, and here where is the end, okay, system dot out dot println. Here I'll say string index, we are going to get the specific messages, right, which exception got occurred and all. We'll get with this kind of approach we are going to get the specific messages, right? If the arithmetic exception has occurred in this block of code, then we'll clearly get this message like arithmetic exception got handled. And if we get array index out of bounds exception, then we'll clearly get the message like array index out of bounds exception got handled. If we get string index, then string index out of bounds exception message will be printed in the output. So that's how, using the multiple catch blocks, we can get specific messages. And for the safe side, at the end of all these multiple catch blocks, just provide this exception E, guys. If in case you get an exception out of all this, if you get an exception which is not there in arithmetic or array index and string index, if you are going to get another type of exception from this block of code, the final safe side exception class will sort it out all. Okay, will sort out everything for us, guys. Okay, the final catch block will sort out everything for us. So right click run as Java application. Fine, string index out of bounds, we got a specific message. Instead of generic message like exception got handled, we got a specific message like string index out of bounds exception got handled. And similarly guys, if this catch blocks, if you are going behind this catch blocks, for example, if you are going behind this exception classes, okay, there are some situations where we not only get exceptions, we also may get errors. Okay, so the exception class cannot handle the errors. Okay, there are like two types of errors. Like one is a direct error, like there's no possibility of handling that error. Okay, it's not an exception. Errors are of two types, which can be handled and which cannot be handled. So there are errors like which cannot be handled. Such kind of errors cannot be taken by exception, guys. Okay, errors which can be handled, that is exception type of errors, can only be handled by this exception class. Okay, or if this particular code is resulting in some error which is not an exception, okay, in that case this exception class cannot handle. For more safe side, if you want this catch blocks to be more safer, okay, at the final moment you can say throwable. As explained in one of the previous videos where I explained exception hierarchy, I explained you throwable is a parent class of this exception class in Java, right? So this exception class can only handle the exceptions. Different type of exceptions can be handled because this is the parent of all the exception classes. But throwable is a parent of the exception class. It can not only handle the exceptions but also the errors. Okay, in the Java programs, not only the exceptions but also the errors. Okay, so if you are in a situation where even after keeping this exception class, if the things are not sorting out, okay, simply put the throwable, guys. Okay, it will get sorted out. So here, error got handled, I will say. Okay, if not exception, finally error. Okay, it is an error. So right click, run as Java application. Fine. Anyhow, we got string index out of bounds exception. Okay, so like this, guys, you can have multiple catch blocks, and first we have to start with the child exception classes, then exception class. Even after exception class also, if it's not figured out, then we have to go with another catch block which has a throwable class. Okay, this is the final parent class in the exception hierarchy. Okay, which can handle both errors and exceptions. This one can handle only exceptions. All types of exception can be handled here. This one, both errors and exceptions. This one only string index out of bounds exception. This one only array index out of bounds exception. And this one only arithmetic exception. Like this, guys. Okay, if you come across such kind of situation, you can actually use multiple catch blocks in your Java programs to handle such kind of situations. So guys, this is all about the multiple catch blocks and how to use them in Java. Fine. In the next video session, I'll explain how to print exception details in different ways. So far, we are printing normal print statements. Okay, we are not printing anywhere the exception details. We are directly printing this exception occurred and that exception occurred, but we have not actually printed the details of the exception. Okay, so which I am going to explain how to print the exception details, this object reference. Okay, we can use this object reference to print more details, guys, about this exception. Okay, instead we are simply printing the normal print statement by writing a normal text, okay, related to that exception. But using this object reference, we can actually print out more advanced details into the output. So that thing I'll explain in the next video session by explaining printing exception details in different ways. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.